Good morning. We're going live from First Lutheran Church in just a few minutes. We're glad that you can join us for this Sunday to remember all of the saints.
Good morning. Amber asked me if I would announce what she's going to play for a prelude. It's an improvisation on a Mormon hymn, Come, Come, Ye Saints Who From Their Labors Rest.
Thank you.
Welcome to worship on this All Saints Sunday, where we celebrate the communion of all the saints. This morning, our liturgy is a little different than it ordinarily is. There is not a confession and forgiveness at the beginning of the service. The Eucharistic prayer toward communion will be a little longer. There are also some responses in that prayer where the congregation responds back. And I have to ask you to be a little bit more maybe Baptist than Lutheran when we get to those responses. And so when I say glory, you say glory.
Glory.
Yeah, you know, that kind of thing. So don't be afraid, don't be shy. Singing with all saints today. Please rise as you're able. Our gathering hymn is number 422, and we will sing only the stanzas on the left side.
Thank you. Thank you.
from Daniel. In the first year of King Belshazzar of Babylon, Daniel had a dream and visions of his head as he lay in bed. Then he wrote down the dream. I, Daniel, saw in my vision by night the four winds of heaven stirring up the great sea. And four great beasts came up out of the sea, different from one another. As for me, Daniel, my spirit was troubled within me, and the visions of my head terrified me. I approached one of the attendants and asked him the truth concerning all this. So he said he would disclose to me the interpretation of the matter. As for those four great beasts, four kings shall arise out of the earth, but the holy ones of the Most High shall receive the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, forever and ever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. Sing to the Lord a new song, God's praise in the assembly of the faithful.
Let Israel rejoice in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their ruler.
Let them praise their Maker's name with dancing. Let them sing praise with tambourine and harp.
For the Lord takes pleasure in the people and adorns the poor with victory.
Let the faithful rejoice in triumph. Let them sing for the joy of their beds.
Let the praises of God be in their throat, and into their sword in their hands,
to wreak vengeance on the nations, and punishment on the peoples.
To bind their kings in chains, and their nobles with chains of iron.
To inflict on them the judgmental decree. This is a glory for all of God's faithful ones. Hallelujah. A reading from Ephesians. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of Him who accomplishes all things according to His counsel and will, so that we, who are the first to be set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of His glory. In Him you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in Him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance, toward redemption as God's own people, to the praise of His glory. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus, and your love toward all the saints, and for this reason, I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know Him, so that, with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which He has called you. What are the riches of His glorious inheritance among the saints? And what is the immeasurable greatness of His power for us who believe, according to the working of His great power? God put this power to work in Christ when He raised Him from the dead and seated Him at the right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And He has put all things under His feet, and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is His body, the fullness of Him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Chapter 6. Glory to you, Lord.
Then Jesus
looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day, and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. For that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets. But I say to you that listen, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you, and if anyone takes away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. Dear siblings in Christ, grace to you and peace from God the Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. I see you. These are the words I heard at a conference, and it wasn't even in the context of the conversation at the conference, but the speaker was doing a Q&A or something like that, and I had a comment or a question. And there were a lot of hands up, so I put mine up, I took it down, you know, just look at this side of the room again, I put it up again, and she said, "I see you." And those words actually hit me at a lot of different levels. I was, as many of you know, the fourth child in my family. My brother was 14 years older, my sister was 11 years older, the next sister was 5 years older. And we lived in the middle of nowhere. So I spent a lot of time feeling unseen. I know that feeling. And then I went to a liberal arts college where having, you know, being a national merit scholar makes you about average. I was never seen at St. Olaf. I hope you are. Okay, that's funny. That's all that mattered, y'all. I met my husband there, Kathy. But so many times and for so many reasons, people feel unseen. Go visit in a nursing home. Sit down and hold someone's hand. Because very often, people who are living there don't feel seen. Minorities of all types don't feel seen when the systems around them are set to majority norm. And majority norm even means those who are able-bodied. We didn't see our friend Sarah for a while. And it is so good to see you walking. We don't see the pain that the people sitting right next to us carry. And so when someone sees us, really sees us, it feels good to be seen, to be known. On this All Saints Sunday, we remember the saints who have gone on ahead of us, but have left holes here for us in our hearts, in our lives, in our pews. We remember Ruth Johnson, who lived to be really, really old, but raised her family and left an imprint on this church. Shirley Schmidt, without whom we wouldn't have Chuck Nelson and family. Anders is a preacher now, carrying on the good news for grandson. Jim Spiker. Jim and Kathy used to hold down that back pew with good. Logan Oakley, gone far too soon. Diana Riley. There's a big hole in this church. But she sings with the saints now. Connie Swanson. She asked hard questions and had a heart that was big. And when we have our mitten tree this year, there's going to be a lot less hats on it. Because she knit, and it didn't matter if she knit for a beloved family member or for a homeless person. She knit beautifully, and she liked her soft yarn. John Perrin, for the first years I was here, John and Gwen were with Jerry and Lois and Gray in the kitchen before any of us to this got here. They were making coffee and enjoying good company and preparing the hospitality of this church. Kenny Olmsted, firefighter. Mary Kay Hubble. Many of us don't know her, but she was from the Hawkinson family. The Hawkinson family did all of the woodworking here. These doors are 24 feet tall, and they are on hinges that work better than probably most of our bedroom closet doors. Susie Schroeder, daughter of the congregation, had a lot of health conditions, but she was beloved by her family and by God. And Lil Bershaw. God saw them all. God knew them all, as God knows us, sees us. And I want to draw us into our lessons today. In our first reading, which seems a little odd, because Daniel, the book of Daniel, is a little odd. It's apocalyptic. But I want to break it down into something beautiful. Daniel had a vision, and in that vision he saw great beasts coming up out of the sea. Four great beasts. And when it was interpreted to him, the four, in apocalyptic literature usually represents earthly something. The four winds, the four directions. Four is a number that represents earthly things. And the interpreter said those four beasts represent the four great kings of the world. Only they're not great, they're tyrants. But, and the last line is what's the most important in this and any of our apocalyptic literature, like the book of Revelation. But the holy ones of the Most High shall receive the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever. Forever and ever. We talked about this in one of our Bible studies, right? Isn't forever enough? You know, forever is infinite. But we close our version of the Lord's Prayer with forever and ever. Amen. The book of Daniel takes it one step further. It says forever. Forever and ever. Friends, we're talking about eternity. And that's what All Saints is about. We are visitors, all of us, in this world. But God is forever and ever. God is forever. God sees the tyrants of this world. And all the way back in the book of Daniel, when the believers were tremendously persecuted, apocalyptic literature comes out of persecution. Daniel has a vision, and the vision breaks down to this: I see the tyrants, Daniel, and I see you. And God reigns forever. Fear not. Ephesians is a little closer to our understanding of All Saints Day. Paul writes to the Ephesians, and he has great thanksgiving and joy in his heart as he writes to them. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints. He called them saints there too. And for this reason I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I do not cease to give thanks. I could write this about this congregation this morning. I do not cease to give thanks. I've been here 10 years. So I've been doing some reflecting, you know, in this last month or so. My first Sunday was All Saints Sunday. And I'll tell you something that I did. were the oldest at the top, and went down the line to the youngest. And a huge percentage of our congregation in 2012 was over 80. Another big chunk of us was already over 70. And what that tells a pastor is I'm going to love these people, and then I'm going to have to say goodbye to a lot of them. At this 10-year mark, I've done 127 funerals here. Many of them used to sit in the pews next to you all. And I still remember where they sat. Now, that was Connie's spot over there. They had their places. Diana. I could list them all. We saw them. But we did not see them as completely as God saw them. As God sees you. And so in our gospel text, Jesus makes this super clear. Jesus looked up at his disciples. He saw them. And he starts, and this is the way Luke portrays this. This is a sermon on the plain. The sermon on the mount, which is similar but doesn't have the woes. It's in Matthew chapter 5. But this is blessings and woes, because that's what the gospel writer Luke does. You remember in Magnificat? My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, for he's lifted the poor. He's filled the hungry, the rich will go away empty. And this is a continuation of that writing. Blessed are the poor and the hungry and those who weep and those who are persecuted. Because the Christians would be persecuted as Jesus was also punished and put on the cross. Jesus said, I see that are hurting. But in Luke's gospel, Jesus also says, I see you as well, who have everything, who are filled, who are laughing, who do the persecuting. I see you too. God doesn't miss anything, just like God did not miss the tyrants in the book of Daniel. God doesn't miss anything. And Jesus is telling his disciples which team they're on. We're on that team. One thing to hold in our hearts, though, is, this is a little grammar thing, all of the yous in this gospel text are plural. You don't go through anything alone unless you choose to. And we've seen countless examples of how that works and how God works through us in this congregation. I just love that because of Audrey Dahlin's friends doing a rummage sale for her. I'm probably going to embarrass you guys. But John McCulloch and his fiance Faith are going to be eating at the same dining room table that his grandparents and Audrey Russell shared many, many, many meals at. And that makes me feel like Oh, this communion of saints thing is really real. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. This is why Paul can write his letters with such joy and such love. Because when God does something that other people might call a coincidence, we're like, I saw that. I know what you did there. I saw that. And God says back, because I see you. Dear fellow saints, you are seen. And you are beloved. Hold on to that. And if you can't hold on, ask somebody to help you hold on. Because we're all in this together. The body of Christ, the communion of saints. Amen.
Give bishops, pastors, deacons, and lay leaders the will to carry the church forward and discern your will for the future. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive our prayer.
Holy One, the earth is yours and all that dwells within it. Care for places ravaged by natural disasters. Quell raging fires and halt destruction caused by flooding. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive our prayer.
Holy One, you raise up leaders to guide your people. Kindle them a passion to care for others, a desire to seek the common good, and the courage to love their enemies. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive our prayer.
Holy One, you bless those who are poor, hungry, and reviled. Provide food, housing, and security to all who are vulnerable and in crisis. May those who have more than enough give generously. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive our prayer.
Holy One, hold us in community with one another. Nurture a spirit of abundant hospitality and intentional inclusion among us, welcoming the gifts of adults and children. Inspire creative visions for our life together. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive our prayer.
Holy One, we remember in thanksgiving all those who have died. Wipe away our tears and comfort us with the promise of everlasting life in you. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive our prayer.
Accept these prayers, gracious God, and those known only to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
and the forgotten, we bless you, O God, for you provide us with water and food. With all the faithful in cities and our farms and mansions and huts, past and present, we worship you, O God, for you shelter the generations. With all your holy people, those who ministered in the church, those who served the poor, and all who walked the way of the cross, we glorify you, O God, for in Jesus, you journeyed with us on earth. With Paul and the evangelists, we remember the meal of your Son. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With Peter and all the martyrs, we honor Christ's death, saying, "Amen."
Amen. Amen.
With Mary Magdalene and all the apostles, we proclaim his resurrection, shouting, "Amen."
Amen.
With John and all the theologians and mystics, we look for his return and pleading, "Amen."
Amen.
With the Virgin Mary and all who sang of your greatness, we pray for the power of the Spirit. Visit this gathering, this bread and this cup, with the presence of the body and blood of Christ. Form us into a communion of service and infuse your earth with the wholeness we seek. With grandparents and godparents, with the church universal, and especially with Ruth Johnson, Shirley Schmidt, Jim Spiker, Logan Oakley, Diana Riley, Connie Swanson, John Perrin, Kenny Olmsted, Mary Kay Hubble, Susan Schrader, and Leo Busher. Lead us to a future we cannot yet see, and at the end, draw all humanity to yourself. Now with all of the family you saved by your love, we shout blessing.
Blessing.
Glory.
Glory.
Wisdom.
Wisdom.
Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving.
Honor.
Honor.
Power.
Power.
Might.
Might.
Be to our God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
This table is hosted by our Lord Jesus, and in that you are welcome to come receive the body and blood of Christ and be the body of Christ together. And now the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace forever.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of abundant table, you have refreshed our hearts in this meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road that we might serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let's welcome Bob up for a second.
Thank you. Pastor Pam was in her sixth year of being minister here, pastor here, when Amber and I joined this church. And in the 4 years that we've been members, we have learned about the love for Pastor and her whole family from the very beginning, in 2012. Family love for Pastor Pam, Pastor Vince, for Christina and Zach, for David and Becca, and for a few dogs and cats. Family love. And in that love, our church family has grown to be a loving, giving, caring family, doing ministry in what we understand about chapter 25 in the book of Matthew, where Christ says, "Inasmuch as you've done it to the least of these, my brothers and sisters, you've done it to me." And so we believe that it's God's work and it's our hands every day. And we give thanks for being part of a church that truly welcomes everybody with no asterisk. The only asterisks we have here are the ones in the bulletin that invites us to stand, if we're able to. No asterisks. So, our cup fills full to overflowing. In that overflow, we are honored to be able to share our pastor with the wider church at the Synod level. Part of her time is our gift to the greater church, and we're blessed to do that. So today, we celebrate Pastor Pam's 10th anniversary of being pastor here. On the 20th of this month, we will have a reception in the hospitality hall after worship with goodies, food, right?
Potluck,
yes, potluck on the 20th. So we celebrate also your knowledge, your skills for ministry, and your passion for ministry. We share that. Thank you, Pastor Pam.
We almost got a full set.
It's a blue chasuble.
It's for Edmund.
Yeah, so really the meaning of the chasuble is that you're covered. And I celebrate, you may notice that sometimes, especially on festivals, I will step out right before the communion and put on a chasuble. And especially at festivals, it's a representation, almost like a tablecloth, if you will, that we are all covered in love. And so when I put this on, you think of yourselves being held close by God, covered in God's love. Thank you all. This has been wonderful. And God bless us with much more time together.
Blessing.
Receive the benediction. Go now with your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love open to all God's people. Bless those who curse you, love those who hate you, and treat others as you would wish them to treat you. And may God give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation. May Christ Jesus count you among his saints for eternity, and may the Holy Spirit mark you out for fullness of redemption. Amen.
Amen. Go in peace. Christ be with you.
Thanks.